Right. Listen.
Who are you voting for?
I'm an American. If you don't vote, then you can't complain about who your rival is.
What did you think about the Pia girl getting...
Disgraceful. She had real sex appeal. She had the good look. I liked her. But I didn't vote that week, and I blame myself.
Right. You know what's going to happen now? She's going to be the most famous one of them all. Because
she already got a record.
It's never the winner. It's the person who...
Right. Yeah. Who wants to win American Idol?
I'm calling for hearings, investigating what went wrong. So you do watch it. You watch it for Stephen Tyler. Did you first think Stephen Tyler made a terrible mistake because he's so iconic? I mean, he's Stephen Tyler. He's a brilliant musician, one of my favorites.
Sure.
Did you think it was kind of a sellout that he went to American Idol?
I didn't think it was a sellout. I just thought it was. I thought it was strange. I thought, shouldn't he be doing an Aerosmith record or something? What? And then I watched it and I understood why they want him on the show.
I understand
he's
why,
perfect for the show.
I understand why they want him. It gives them a tremendous credibility. Yeah. But why does he want to? And what if I told you? I'll tell you why.
Oh.
Because I know people. He did it for the money.
Think so?
Know it.
Is it tons of bread?
It's about $15 million a year.
Holy moly.
And he needed the bread. Now, why does a guy in Aerosmith
do that?
You would do it.
That's Nirvana money.
Yeah. He got money. $15 million. J-Lo got around. I happen to know she did it for the money, too. She needed the money.
I can understand that.
She didn't need the money.
Come on. I mean, these are people who made a lot of money, right?
I'll fill you in.
How much
afterwards.
Do you need?
No. She needed it.
What a high lifestyle there. She's not in a track
everything.
Home.
I have dossiers on people.
Oh, my God.
That's right. Randy, the other judge,
yeah,
he gets $300 an episode. They even pay his taxes.
The musician of the group.
All right. Here we go. Let me listen to a little of the boys playing some of their music here. Let's see what we have on our hands here with Rope. This part I like.
Psychedelic.
Is that you?
That's me.
I like that part.
Unconventional accordion.
But this could go wrong.
I like this. That's bouncing heavy.
It's a headphones
yeah.
record.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Wear headphones. Now we're in the garage.
Here we go. Taylor's the high voice.
I'm a girl.
I'm not bullshitting you. It's a winner.
Thank you.
Cool.
You're on to something with that one.
That's
like
our first single.
Now, when you say a single, where the hell do you go to play this? All the rock stations are almost gone. You got KROQ in Los Angeles. We'll play it. I don't even know in New York if there's a rock station left. Is there? There's only classic rock.
I don't really know how it works anymore, but I know that the... Yeah, like DC lost HFS.
Yeah, it's almost like, why even bother putting out a single?
Isn't there an alternative station?
Satellite, I guess.
Satellite.
You know,
well, we'll play it. We have 50 stations that'll play it.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Real quick, a couple of questions, and then I'll let you guys out of here, and you can go back to your kids. Joe, go ahead. You're on the air.
Hey, Howard. How you doing? Is that Dave?
What's up, Joe?
It's how Dave and Taylor.
I got to just Taylor. I just wanted to tell Dave, man, that on that Paul McCartney tribute, You fucking smoked the house. You were like the
that, why are you laughing when he says that? That's true. I have to
see.
Because
he said, you fucking smoked the house.
Well, you did smoke it.
Thanks. That's
why I'm laughing. Was that a thrill for you? I mean, I
love...
Yeah,
is that fun?
Are the Beatles your inspiration? Were they the reason?
They were the first band I ever really loved.
You didn't appear to be nervous at all playing in front of that crowd. Paul McCartney.
The Kennedy Center thing?
Yeah, Obama, the whole thing. You didn't. You just get out there and you do it. Were you?
No, I'm pretty nervous.
You were?
I always get
nervous. How does that manifest?
That ass-kicking, that was fucking incredible.
How does that thank you, Joe. How does that nervousness manifest itself?
On SNL,
right?
See how I was spazzing out so hard and snapping my neck around.
Now, you were comfortable because you were with Foo Fighters. You were with the band.
It's still kind of nerve-wracking to do things like that.
Oh, yeah.
But
scary.
You still get nervous about that?
Oh.
Even Saturday Night Live? Really?
It's the worst. That's the one that you get most nervous about.
See, people are shocked to hear that. Like, when I go on Letterman, the reason I do it like every 5 years.
Do you get nervous?
I hate it. It's not nerves. It's just I put a lot into it, and I want it to go off properly.
You can't relax.
I don't relax, and it ruins my week. It ruins the whole fucking
absolutely.
Week.
That's
I can just go on.
Now, when they tell us, okay, you guys got SNL, and, you know, that's 2 or 3 months from now, I'm just nervous.
Every day.
And
when you think about it, like, your balls shift and your asshole goes...
See, I never thought that of you guys.
You think musicians have the song to hang on to.
Oh, yeah. I'm like, you guys have done it a million times, and what's
the
difference?
Yeah, but if we fuck that song up on SNL,
live,
in front of everybody.
You're right.
An Ashley moment, or like, I faint and fall on my face.
Well, you're right. If you trip, it's going to be all over the news. If you and not only that, if they fuck up the sound... Because you guys don't lip sync, because you actually play live, I noticed the sound was very good on Saturday Night Live this week. A lot of times I've seen guys get screwed.
Yeah.
Got screwed. Remember that?
Did he?
Yeah.
We got a guy named JC that works for us, and he's sort of like the Obi-Wan Kenobi of our whole scene, and he goes in there and he sits in there with the sound guys the camera guys.
He's worth his weight in gold because that can really screw you up. All right, take one more.
Wait a minute, I want to know what Taylor's spitting.
I'm dipping.
Oh, are you doing chew?
Okay.
Yeah, I quit smoking.
But that chew, though, will give you mouth cancer.
Well, I know, I'm tapering.
This is a tapering off kind of thing?
It's better than smoking.
No kidding, you like that tape? Man, that's hardcore.
It's fucking gross. It's the
you don't
thing
chew,
in the
do
world.
You?
No.
You love him because he does all the wrong things.
He does all the things that I shouldn't be doing.
Right. You admire him because you're so under control, no drugs, no this, no that. He does everything, and you admire it.
I just sit and laugh.
You live vicariously.
What a dumb shit.
Is he your Joe Perry, in a sense? Because I noticed Steven Tyler, when he performs, he has one... Joe and him, they look cool together. I see you like the way... You like his
whole... Well, he and I are definitely best friends and have a good connection musically. And,
right.
You know, when we're on stage, I probably spend most of the time focused on Taylor. And,
right.
You know.
Because he has the look, right?
Well, we met.
He has the look. He does.
He just loves looking at me.
He takes his shirt off and he's got
literally when we met,
he has a man crush on you, and I don't give a fuck what anyone says. Am I right or am I wrong?
It's back and forth. When we met,
you guys ever touch each other's penises?
That one time.
Take it easy.
Is it a bromance?
You guys have a bromance, right?
The day we met, it was like long lost brothers,
right?
It really was.
You know,
right away.
People don't like to admit this, but a lot of it has to do with luck. I don't give a fuck that you're in Nirvana.
He picked him because of his looks.
No, listen, he's a dynamite drummer. I mean, you can really... Okay. I mean, I've watched you. You're fantastic. And yes, Dave has a crush. He does. Listen, if I had to date a man, it would be either one of these two guys. Why not? I like it. It's about the look. You still have to look cool when you're up on stage.
Well, it's got a nice personality, too.
But you have to have a cool, youthful look. Like, I was looking at Dave on TV. You got the long hair, but it's still dark. You don't have any gray. You know, you look youthful. You have to, you know? That's it. Which one of these two guys would you fuck, Robin?
Oh, my God.
Dave or Taylor? I'll
fuck both of them.
That's going to be quite a night.
One last question.
That's going to be quite a night.
Maybe we could touch penises. We've never done it before.
It's going to get weird.
You guys ever see each other naked?
I don't know.
No. All right. Well, Raleigh, go ahead. You have the last word, and then I'm going to let the boys out of here.
Oh, hey,
it's a Brett. Thanks for taking my call, Howard. These guys are my Beatles, but I just want to know, on the Stern Show Shuffle, they had Cordy Love, that Hall on there talking shit that Dave wrote that song Hero about Kurt, and I heard him.
The song Corey Hero was about Kurt?
No, not no. Really.
Who was it about? Who was my hero?
I sort of wrote that song about about this friend of mine, this guy Pete Stahl.
Pete Stahl?
Yeah, Pete Stahl.
What is Pete
I was
Stahl?
In a band with him years ago. He was this dude that, like, basically, he was my mentor. When I first dropped out of high school, I joined his band, and he taught me how to make it on the road.
I'm not following that. What is Pete Stahl?
Pete Stahl. Oh, my goodness.
I thought it was a disease. It's some guy you had Pete Stahl.
Something you get on your feet.
He was your hero because he showed you the ropes.
Yeah, he's just like a good dude, you know.
Whenever I hear that song, I think about my dad.
Really?
Yeah.
Good.
There goes your hero.
Because that's what
because
yeah,
because
be
I
like
think
that.
About when I it's not that when I was a little boy, I worshipped him because he was my dad. And there goes my I get emotional thinking about it. All right. I'm going to pass off. I'm going to go off. Don't ever sing that song around me.
Make I won't. I promise.
Don't cry.
I don't want to see Howard Stern
I'm very
cry.
Fucking much. He might have come the closest to get me to cry with that song. All right, listen.
Next
Dave
time.
Grohl, Taylor Hawkins, you two guys are some of my favorite people.
It's good to be back, Howard.
I'm
we shouldn't wait
you.
So long.
Yeah.
Well, you're a busy man. I even said, I don't know with these Foo Fighters. Very
we
busy.
Didn't even know you were going to show up today.
Yeah, I said, I don't know. But I'm so glad you came in.
Thanks.
I wish you a lot of success with the new record. I guess you're going to be on tour everywhere, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Foo Fighters' new album, Wasted Light, featuring the single Rope, is in stores tomorrow. For additional information and tour dates, go to foofighters.com. Very important website that you must be on. Boys, anything you want to say to the audience before you leave? I'll leave it with the last words. Taylor, anything?
Oh, man. Thanks for hanging with us for freaking 16 years. It's insane. We're so lucky.
We're so lucky that we get to go play shows to so many people now. We never expected that. We didn't think this would last this long, and it's nice that people still love rock and roll.
That's great, and I'm happy for you. You're really good guys. All right, we'll be back right after these words.
Howard Stern Show. Giving the interviewer a hard time. It's Billy Bob Thornton on Canadian radio, QTV.
And that was true for you, Billy Bob. Growing up, it was a sort of a combo of Stones and Monkees and Buck Owens.
I just liked baseball when I was a kid. I subscribed to a magazine called Famous Monsters of Filmland, which the publisher was a guy named Forrest J. Ackerman, who passed away recently.
Where's the music? Where's the music fit into that?
Music? No, it was a monster magazine.
Right, right. But given that you seem to be quite passionate about music, I was wondering about your...
Would you say that to Tom Petty?
Yeah.
Really? Would you explain why it's not a hobby?
Are you reacting to the fact that I said...
Yeah,
the...
I am. Since you're instructed not to talk about shit like that, yeah, I am reacting to that, yeah.
Howard Stern Show. Of America as we know it. Recently, one of the most widely read financial journalists in the country explained how a single event in the next 12 months will likely shake the very foundation of our nation. He says this big event has nothing to do with war or the stock market, yet it will change everything about your normal way of life. Could this really happen? This same man was among the first to predict the collapse of GM, Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, and America's biggest mall owner, General Growth Properties, a few years ago. In fact, Barron's called his work a dire prophecy. And now, to get the word out on what he believes will be the most important event in our nation's past 50 years, this journalist has created an eye-opening video you can watch online for free. You may never think about America the same way again.
You can find the video at www.endofamerica13.com. That's endofamerica13.com. Watch the free video at www.endofamerica13.com. That's endofamerica13.com.
If you're the one out of every four online investors who have thrown in the towel and completely given up on the idea of making money in the stock market, this message is for you. Hi, this is Preston James. How would you like to know with 86% accuracy that a stock's price today is going to be substantially higher 3 to 6 months from now? Just imagine knowing you're going to be right 86% of the time. Well, get ready to write down the name of this website because I'm going to tell you how this is possible once you discover a little-known piece of news that practically forces a stock to go higher, even in today's market. This piece of news is something I discovered in the middle of the last stock market wipeout. Not only will I tell you what this piece of news is, I'll show you how it's working right now, right in the middle of this so-called economic recovery. For a limited time, you can go to this website and I'll tell you all about this little-known piece of news and how to use it in your trading. Just go to buriedtreasurexm.com. That's buriedtreasurexm.com. There's no credit card required and no rah-rah pitch-a-thon to attend in some nearby hotel. That's buriedtreasurexm.com.